Hello students, welcome to the class of Sachin Sir Physics, the finest and the easiest way to learn the concept. So in this class, we will learn one more concept from your chapter, wave optics, and this topic, this point is very, very important related to the action of the light. But what you will learn in this class is all about diffraction, which is totally different than your interference. But you know, my rule is, before I start my class, let's talk about the previous lecture. In the previous lecture, dear students, we were discussing about interference. So the very first question you should think, that what is interference? Interference means it is the kind of physical effect produced by the superposition of the two waves at a single point. Such a type of physical effect is called interference, and that interference can be of different types. It is of two types. Number one, which is called your constructive interference. Number two is called your destructive interference. Then we see that this constructive interference is also called as which kind of fringes? Bright fringes. And your destructive interference is called as your another point, which is called dark fringes. What do you mean by this bright fringes as well as dark fringes? In the previous video, you have also seen that when we were discussing about Young's double slit experiment, then we found that on a screen at a center point, we always get a central maximum, and above that central maximum, we find that there is one bright spot, which is called your bright fringes. And then above that bright fringes, we get first dark fringes, which is called first maxima, then first minima, second maxima, second minima. We have derived the formula of that. Then what is the formula of path difference? Yes, path difference is written as x small d divided by capital T is equal to r2 minus r1 is equal to n lambda. N lambda for your constructive interference, and for destructive interference, it is given by this equation x small d divided by capital D is equal to r2 minus r1 is equal to 2n minus 1 lambda divided by 2. Then we also derived the distance between the two consecutive bright fringes as well as distance between the two consecutive dark fringes. After learning all that concept based on interference, let's start over this class, and this class is all about diffraction. So the very first point which you have to remember is, what is the phenomena of diffraction? Let's understand with one demonstration. All right, suppose we have two types of wave, maybe in the form of light wave or maybe in the form of your sound waves, and both the waves are traveling in a medium. दोनों भाई आराम से चल रहे हैं मीडियम में, एंड सडनली व्हाट हैपेंस, दे फाउंड देयर इज सम ऑब्स्टिकल ऑन देयर वे. रास्ते में उन्हें कोई ऑब्स्टिकल मिल जाता है, ऐसे एक टावर मिल जाता है सपोज कर लेते हैं. तो ये जो लाइट वेव्स चल रही है या जो साउंड वेव्स चल रही है, होता ये है कि जैसे ही ये लाइट वेव्स इसके एज पे कोलाइड करता है या फिर एनकाउंटर करता है, देन इट गेट्स बेंड ओवर देयर एज. So this bending of the waves from the edge of that obstacle is called your diffraction. Are you getting my point? Let's repeat. If the waves encounters the obstacle like a slit, then it gets bent over the edge of that obstacle is called diffraction. Keep this thing in your mind. Do not go for the rectification. Waves are traveling. They found there is obstacle, then it gets bent from the edge. Such a phenomenon is called diffraction. To understand this concept, let's talk about one more example which is always comes in our daily life experience. All right, so is example ko aapko feel karne ki zarurat hai, fatafat link hona shuru ho jayega. अब मैं वो एग्जांपल आपको एक्सप्लेन करता हूँ, फिर डिफ्रैक्शन और अच्छे से समझ पड़ेगा आपको कि डिफ्रैक्शन एक्चुअल में होता क्या है. सपोज इन दिस क्लासरूम there is one door and one person is standing over here. The room is packed. Another person is over here. Then these two person can hear the sound of each other, but they cannot see each other. That means what? If we put an obstacle between these two person, then when they start talking with each other, then they can listen each other, they can hear each other, but they cannot see him. Why? Because sound waves diffracts more comparison to the light wave. If the person can see each other, that means light waves are diffracting more. And if the person can hear each other, that means what? Sound waves gets diffract more. But in this example, though that person cannot see each other, so we can say light waves cannot diffract more, but the sound waves diffract more. Now the question should be arises in our mind, why this light wave do not diffract? So to understand this phenomena, again we will understand with one concept which is called ripple tank experiment. Must remember, by using the concept of ripple tank experiment, we are going to understand why this light waves diffracts easily, but why this sound waves diffracts easily, but the light waves cannot diffract easily. Okay, so the very first things which you have to notice is, I have already written this theory, this point, which is very, very helpful for your exams. This will help you a lot while you are writing your notes. So please take a note. I'm going to explain one more time what is diffraction. This will be the perfect definition. When waves encounter the obstacle, when the waves encounter the obstacle like slit, then it always gets bent near the edge. This phenomena is called diffraction. Okay. Then light and sound energy both travels in the form of waves. दोनों waves के form में travel करती है, चाहे वो sound energy हो या फिर वो light energy हो. Alright. But sound waves shows this kind of effect, while light waves do not show this effect of diffraction. Why this is not showing the kind of effect? We already understood with one example of that door and that two person. अभी और भी हम अच्छे से detail में समझेंगे. To understand this, let's take an example of ripple tank experiment. Now, what is ripple tank experiment? There is a simple setup. You have to take a container full of water. आप एक container ले लीजिए जो पानी से भरा हुआ है. And on that container, take a two slits, or you can say take a two blocks like this, which will act as an obstacle for that journey of the waves. Waves के journey में ये एक obstacle की तरह काम करेगा मेरे dear students. All right. So there is two containers. In this container, you can see the gap is more, while in this container, the gap is taken short. थोड़ा इसे short कर देते हैं, इसे ज़्यादा कर देते हैं phenomena समझने के लिए. And you can also observe that there is one wooden strip we have taken. Why we are taking this wooden strip? Just because by tapping that wooden strip on the surface of the water, we can produce the linear waves. You can say the plane waves. ये क्या करना है आपको? Water के surface पे periodically tap करना है. So when you do tapping on that surface of the water, this will produces linear waves like this on the surface of the water. So these are the waves, and the gap between them, you can see there is lambda. What is lambda? It is actually the wavelength of that waves produces because of that tapping of the wooden strip on the surface of the water. All right. So let's see the effect behind this. When you tap this wooden strip, this will produces a linear waves like this. Then what we see from this experiment, when this gap is taken more, then the emerging waves produces from this wooden strip remains almost linear. See, there is linear waves, and after emerging from this slit, this again remains almost, एकदम हम कह सकते हैं कि लगभग उसके जैसा ही स्ट्रेट है. उसका डिफ्रैक्शन कम हुआ, दैट मीन्स यू कैन से कि वहां पे बेंडिंग बहुत कम हो रही, बिकॉज गैप ज्यादा है. एंड यू कैन सी इन दिस एग्जाम्पल, इफ वी टेक शॉर्ट दिस गैप, इफ वी रिड्यूसेस दिस गैप, देन यू कैन सी देयर इज मोर बेंडिंग ऑफ दिस वेव्स. So from this example, these two examples, this two simple setup of that ripple tank experiment, we can be able to know that when the gap is more, diffraction is less. When the gap is short, diffraction is more. Now, in this example, we have taken a distance is exactly equals to 5 times of wavelength produces by this wooden strip. While in this case, the distance or the gap is smaller, which is taken as 2 lambda, and here we can take we have taken a value of this distance is equal to 5 lambda. That means what? We can say that diffraction depends on ratio of lambda by d. It is very important From this simple experiment, we can say that diffraction depends on the ratio of lambda by d. Why I am saying this? Because if lambda by d is more, then this distance will be less. अगर आप इसे बहुत ज़्यादा कर देते हो रेशियो को, एंड टू गेट द वैल्यू ऑफ दिस रेशियो मोर, देन यू हैव टू टेक शॉर्टर वैल्यू ऑफ दिस गैप. तो अगर ये गैप कम है तो ये बहुत ज़्यादा होगा, रेशियो बहुत ज़्यादा होगा. और अगर रेशियो बहुत ही ज़्यादा होगा, दैट मीन्स इफ़ यू आर टेकिंग लैम्ब्डा बाय डी इज मोर, देन देयर इज लेस डिफ्रैक्शन. All right. Similarly, you can take another example for that. Please take a note, dear student. If lambda by d is more, this complete ratio is very huge, then distance is very less. Sorry, I have to use this example. Distance is very less, then there is more diffraction. That means it fully depends on the ratio of this lambda by d. Now you can get one more reviews of this experiment. If lambda by d is less, then this value will be more. And if the distance is huge, then you can see these emerging waves from the slits is almost linear. So we can say there is less diffraction. अब इसे आप अपने माइंड में प्लीज़ स्टोर करके रख लीजिए, बिकॉज ये बहुत ही इंपॉर्टेंट फिनोमिना है रिलेटेड टू द डिफ्रैक्शन. डिफ्रैक्शन ऑलवेज डिपेंड्स ऑन लैम्ब्डा डिवाइडेड बाय डी. इफ द रेशियो इज मोर, देर इज ग्रेटर डिफ्रैक्शन, बिकॉज देर इज लेस वैल्यू ऑफ डी. गैप जितना शॉर्ट होगा, डिफ्रैक्शन उतना ही ज़्यादा होगा. जैसे साउंड वेव्स ईजिली उस दरवाजे के पास, उस डोर के पास, जो भी गैप्स है वहाँ से डिफ्रैक्ट होते हुए उस पर्सन के दूसरे साइड तक पहुँच जाती है, बट लाइट वेव्स नहीं कर पाती, बिकॉज लाइट वेव्स के केस में कुछ ऐसा होता होगा. अभी भी हम उसे और एग्जाम्पल से समझेंगे. एंड द सेकेंड केस, वन लैम्ब्डा बाई डी इज वेरी लेस, देन ड्यू टू द ह्यूज वैल्यू ऑफ गैप, देर इज लेस चांस ऑफ दैट डिफ्रैक्शन. ऑल राइट, नाउ वाई दिस लाइट वेव्स डू नॉट डिफ्रैक्ट, सो देयर इज द रीजन. Dear student, if we talk about sound waves, then can you tell me the typical value of that wavelength for that sound waves? Sound waves ki wavelength almost kis range mein hoti hai? Sochiye, it is almost in meter. So suppose ye jo wavelength hai, wo hum keh dete hain ki wo 1 meter hai. Suppose kar liya. Abhi yaad rakhna hai aapko, sound waves almost meter mein hota hai. बट जो लाइट वेव्स होता है वो ऑलमोस्ट एंगस्ट्रॉम में होता है. द विजिबल लाइट इज ऑलवेज इन एंगस्ट्रॉम. यू कैन से 6000 एंगस्ट्रॉम, यू कैन से 4000 एंगस्ट्रॉम. सो नाउ द विथ ऑफ द डोर इज ऑलमोस्ट मीटर, ये भी मीटर में होता है. सो व्हेन यू डू टेक अ रेशियो ऑफ दिस टू, लैम्ब्डा बाई डी इज 1 मीटर डिवाइडेड बाई 1 मीटर, अगेन यू आर गेटिंग द वैल्यू ऑफ 1 मीटर. अब ये तो आया 1 मीटर इन द केस ऑफ योर साउंड वेव्स, बट वॉट विल हैपन इफ वी टेक लाइट वेव्स. सो इन द केस ऑफ लाइट वेव्स, लैम्ब्डा इज ऑलमोस्ट अबाउट 6000 एंगस्ट्रॉम. वॉट यू मीन बाई एंगस्ट्रॉम? इट इज 10^-10. So 6 × 10⁻¹ meter, and the width of that door is almost in meter. जो दरवाजे की चौड़ाई है, width है, वो almost meter में होती है. तो अगर हम यहाँ पे wavelength find करने जाएँ, तो lambda divided by d is equal to 6 × 10⁻¹ upon 1. That means 6 × 10⁻¹, which is very 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 less comparison to this one. Look at this is 1 meter, almost meter, and this one it is 0.00006 times zeros, and then there is 6. It's a very less value. That means which case it is following? This is following this one. The less value of the ratio of that lambda by d there is the less chance of diffraction. This is the biggest reason why light waves do not diffract much more comparison to the sound waves. This is the biggest reason why that person can hear the sound of each other, but they cannot see each other. Alright, so this is the funda of that diffraction. I hope you like the video. If you have any doubt related to this concept, related to this topic, then you can ask your question, ask your doubts, ask your queries in the comment box. Thank you so much for watching this video. And if you have not subscribed the channel, then please subscribe the channel, because it is one of the India's most lovable channel right now, because there is no cost. I am uploading one by one all the topics of the 12 science, and then later I will try to cover the topics also from your 11 science. Thank you so much from my bottom of hearts for watching this channel, watching the videos from Sachin Sir Physics. Thank you.